These are Lizzie's babies. Look, it was Snowball London.
Cracks me up.
What? I gave you your first trimming today. Because I needed to show your bright white. Yes, look how intelligent you are. You just listen to everything.
Oh, you're killing me, girlfriend. London, so these are Lizzie's. They turned 6 weeks old today. Get their vaccinations, so ready to go home in 2 weeks. Oh my gosh, she crashed. He spun out and crashed. The one with the orange ribbon. So these other three are boys. The Cafe Au Lait one's here. Lyle laying at my feet's more golden color, but these two are like the darker cafe color. So there's Lyle with the wavy, the curly shaggy coat. So Lyle with the yellow ribbon. You can see his underneath all that fur. Their coats are just getting so lush and thick and absolutely no shedding. And then this is a lime ribbon here. So lime is another wavy to curly. That's Lincoln, big boy. Lyle, little boy. Lincoln, big boy. And then the orange ribbon, that's Leon. Yes, this is my only little girl left, London. Yeah. So surprised nobody's gotten you yet. Yeah. Saying that's because she wasn't showing off her bright white coat until now, when I could give her a little trim and get rid of some of that baby puppy fur. So, but now you can see the bright white coming out and how absolutely gorgeous and dark that red color is getting. You are gorgeous, gorgeous. Love you. And then Lyle. I know you guys are super sweet. And look at this. You're a good boy too, aren't you? You just listen to every word. Oh, sitting for attention too. That's Leon. They're starting to wear down for the night. So, Lime, there's Lincoln, Lyle, and London. Aw, yeah, getting tired, huh? Yeah, getting tired. It is about 7:30, so yeah, they're winding down for the night. So that's Leon. Very intelligent, calm puppies. Yeah, look at you. Look at you. What a curly boy. See, if you talk in a high pitch, it gets them excited. So that's why I do that. I know it sounds goofy, but it's what you call baby talk. Because these are little babies. London's still playing. She is that poodle prance. Yeah, she may be small now, but doesn't mean too much other than that it's a preemie. Because, well, dogs conceive between a week to 2 weeks, they're actually fertile season. And then when the puppies are born, they all are born at the same time. So you actually just get a puppy that wasn't in gestation as long as the other ones. And usually the smaller ones end up to be the strongest because they always had to push the bigger puppies aside to get to the food. And believe me, she has a fat, chubby belly. Because as you can see now with her fur trimmed down, she's a stocky little baby. Oh, I like the way she has this dark color on her hind legs. That's funny. And that'll continue to get a little darker, more red, more pronounced. Those spots come out more. Because I even see a little few, like, dots on her side coming out again. So the love watching these party colors develop, because you look back at her baby picture when she looked all white and you could barely tell she was a party color, and look how dark she's getting now. Love, love, love the party colors. I keep one in the house. My first party puppy I developed took five generations of golden doodles to get to. It's Miss Buffy. She's party, red and white, lives in the house with me. And
a dark apricot standard poodle that weighs like 38 pounds. So to me, that's what these guys will be, about 38 pounds. And that is just perfect because they do have long legs like a poodle. So, I mean, it makes them pretty tall. So whenever a 38-pound dog, golden poodle, stands up to you, I mean, I'm 5'3", and they're still going to be able to pretty much put their paws almost up to my shoulders and, you know, kind of look at me face to face. So it's a great size. Because they do want to be with you 24/7, so they want to eventually, I mean, they want to sleep in your bed. And that takes to about 7 months old. About 7 months old, you can just leave the crate door open all night and let them run. By then, they've learned everything they need to learn. They know where they can go, where they can't go, what they're allowed to do, and sleep all the way through the night. I know I pulled your ribbon because you are, what color do you have on? Orange. Yep. I'm talking to you. I'm talking to you. Look at you, girl. I just love it. You're just begging for attention. You were so good doing your trim today. When you got groomed, you just stood there and let me do whatever. You didn't care. You are going to be one easygoing puppy. You are going to be easygoing, easy to train. And there's my three boys. My three good boys. Look at you. Those are my good boys. Lyle to the left. Lincoln, right there. And Leon. Another orange ribbon. Yep. I know I pulled your ribbon around. So we can see who you were. You're orange. That's why you were scratching at your neck, because I pulled on your ribbon. But we want to see it so we can easily see who you are in the videos. Where are you going? London. I just love your little prance. You like your name? You might have somebody might have to keep your name. No, they can change it if they want to, but it's good. I like it. Because I like how proud you prance around. Jeez, come here, baby. Come here, baby. Okay. You're a silly girl, aren't you? You want to stay right by my side, don't you, sweetie? Go get those boys, yeah. You're so intelligent, sweet. Say good night. Good night, boys.